name is Ramakrishna. I am a physiotherapy student. My question is, what is the need of Allah to create Adam and Eve and this total universe? What he will get from this? And my second question is, everything is created by someone. So even God must have been created by someone. What is the meaning of Allah?
Brothers asked three questions. The first question, why did God create Adam and Eve and what was his reason to create all this world and humankind? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam and Eve, may peace be upon them both, so that the humankind could come. They were the great, great grandparents. Allah says in Surah Hujurat, chapter number 49, verse number 13, Ya ayyuhan nasu inna khalaqnakum min zakrin wa unsa wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila litarafu. Inna akramakum inda Allahi atqakum inna Allah alimun khabir. O humankind, we have created you from a single pair of male and female, and I've divided you into nations and tribes so that you may recognize each other, not that you may despise each other. And the most honored in the sight of Almighty God is the person who has taqwa. The criteria to judge any human being, it is not wealth, it's not color, it's not caste, it's not creed, it is taqwa, it is God consciousness, it is righteousness, it is piety. So Adam and Eve, peace be upon them both, they were our great, great grandparents, of yours also and of mine also, all humankind. Therefore, I call you a brother. We are brothers in humanity. Allah says, Ya ayyuhan nas, O humankind. And Allah says in Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 70, Walaqad karramna bani Adama. Almighty God has honored all the children of Adam. Whether they are born in India, USA, UK, born in a Hindu family, or a Muslim family, or a Christian family, Allah says He has honored all the Bani Adam. If you are a human being, Allah has honored you. Whether your name is Zakir, Abdullah, Ramu, Shankar, if you are born as a human being, Allah has honored you. Now coming to the question, why has Almighty God created the human beings? Allah has created the human beings because Allah says this is one of His best creation. All the other creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they obey Him. We have the angels. Whatever Almighty God says, the angels obey Him directly. They have no free will. The human being is the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which has a free will. We can either obey Him or disobey Him. So Allah has created such a creation. We are one of His best creation and the best of forms. But we have a choice of either obeying God or disobeying God. If we obey God, we will go to Jannah, we'll go to Swarg, we'll go to heaven. If we disobey Him, we'll go to hell, we'll go to Narak. So this is a test for the hereafter. Allah says in Surah Mulk, chapter number 67, verse number 2, Allazi khalaqal mauta wal hayata. It is Allah who has created death and life to test which of you is good in deeds. So this life is a test for the hereafter. So Allah has created the human beings, and Allah says in Surah Dhariyat, chapter number 51, verse number 56, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. That we have created the jinn and the men not but to worship Him. So we supposed to worship, obey the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a different creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which has the free will of even going against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or obeying Him. All the other things, the stars, the trees, the mountains, the Quran says they do sajda to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They prostrate to Him, they obey Him. We have a free will. Now when Allah has given a free will, with the free will, if we obey Him, we become higher than the angels. With the free will, if we disobey Him, we become the partners of the devil. So He's created us for the test for the hereafter.